Hello, my beautiful Sagittarius. When you are flirting and you're getting to know someone, sometimes you can be very private and just communicate with that person. Other times you announce it to the world. But the one theme that is very typical of a Sagittarius is that if it comes too easily to you, you can get bored. So let's jump into your reading, Sag. Welcome to my channel, Irish Donna Tarot. Sagittarius, you have some amazing cards here. Look at this. I use the Chinese fortune reading cards by Serena Starr, and I take as many as fall out, basically. And look at what you have. This is incredible. Okay, so you have prosperity, forgiveness, travel, marriage. A lot fell out. New beginnings. Dragon energy. And for those of you who do not understand what dragon energy is, it's like having fierce optimism. It's fierce good luck. It gives you a lot of power. It's a point of power in terms of getting your treasure island. The new beginnings are based on the truth that is being told in the cards in this reading. In terms of how you can make things better, what's going sideways, what you can improve, I call this empowerment tarot. I love it when the tarot helps us solve problems so that we aren't idly sitting down, waiting, you know, in our little sofa with our little fan, you know, fanning ourselves, waiting for the world to change. We have the power to change the dynamic of our love life. And that is what we're seeing here. Wisdom. Okay. So Sagittarius, what I'm getting is that in the recent past, somebody that it looks like you've met this person online. We have the Page of Swords. That's the I Spy Gemini card. You know, both of you are seeking enlightenment. But when we get the Star card reversed, we have a situation in which the mutual energy is between you and your love interest is that you've lost faith or hope, because when we get it upright, that's hopes and dreams for love coming true. Right now, you know, you're both energetically in this space of having a sense of losing faith. We see that both of you absolutely are trying to make an offer to one another, but what we're seeing here is that when the Fool is reversed, that's actually making a bad decision in what we're offering, or, you know, something we're doing is a little off kilter, but both of you are doing it. So sometimes it means jumping in too quickly, you know, making a commitment too quickly. But again, it's really saying slow down, you're moving too fast. You know, that it's okay. And of course, now we have your person slowing down. Now they feel as though something has already happened in this connection that makes them feel remorse and regret over what they've done. They may have made an offer that was really not something they can maintain. But again, the remorse and regret card does have a dove at the top when we look at that closely. The way they view you is somebody who doesn't have a foundation, because you cycle through people very quickly. Your person does not feel as though you are stable enough, that you're always juggling too. And this may come about because you have talked maybe too much about your love life with each other. And so they don't see you as a safe bet. Okay, they just don't. Whether that's right or wrong, it's how they view the situation. How do they feel in their heart space? Oh, they're falling hard for you, Sag. They're falling hard for you. The Empress card in the upright is about manifesting love. It's Venus. It's, you know, this is somebody who attracts love to them. So your love partner is very interesting because they are very attractive to other people. We also see this person having great clarity. When we get the Eight of Swords in the upright, it looks as though it's a self-imposed restriction. Usually they hold back, but with you, they can't. They are falling for you hard. If they haven't fallen for you already, they are about to do so. Sagittarius, here you are in your reading. I love the energy of the Wheel of Fortune. Stepping forward very boldly, your person is going to step forward with this King of Wands energy. It's Leo energy. it's the timing is right. We also have Aries energy here. So very interestingly, it looks as though your person is stepping in, trying to take a leadership role to provide a situation in which you will date them exclusively and stop juggling. And they want to build a strong foundation where they believe that you don't typically have a big interest. You know, you don't like to commit as fast as maybe other people. The reason is, Sag, is that you are known for sort of being willing to go spin the wheel at the casino table for love. Sagittarius is actually known as the bachelor sign. Now, when we look at the Nine of Cups reversed, we see when it's upright, it's eat, drink, be merry, wishes come true. When it is upside down, it indicates that you're not quite sure if this can be manifested. This is your hidden mutual energy in this reading. So, Sag, it's telling me that although your person feels that you could be the one, that you don't necessarily know. And both of you are partying or, you know, or spending too much time with other people juggling too, that this could fail if you don't turn those cards upright. Okay. So in the upside down position, a failure to launch, so to speak, is going to take place because there's not a strong foundation. So when we look at the cards, we're really looking for clues on how we can also come to the table and make things better. So again, if it doesn't resonate, it's like a buffet table. If a particular card set does not apply to you, just ignore it. We go on to the next. Now, Spirit is recommending, Sag, that you take a chance on love. Make some plans. Go on a vacation together. Spend some time together. Wheel of Fortune also, Sag, is your sign. So that is about long distance travel. It's about higher levels of thinking, like university, a philosophy class. So it really is saying that you could be the right person for one another. You know, when we get this marriage indicator, we get a travel indicator. Sagittarius, this is travel. This is travel. This is travel. You know, when we look at the Empress card wants the stability of marriage. You know, when we see an abundant Venus, we see prosperity. You know, we have new beginnings. We see the Fool card, but the Fool card has to be, you know, upright, right? So we have to give love a chance. We have to take a look at that and having the wisdom to do it. But the truth be told, everyone knows the right thing, what they need to do here. And so what we see is that as this reading starts to close out, Sag, that you have, both of you have the outcome of being willing to chase the truth, be very honest with each other. And the Ace of Wands, this is a passionate new beginning. You know, very much Aquarius energy with a lot of freedom in it. You know, neither of you have the desire to be a ball and chain around the other person. And you have a lot to say. So let's take a look and see what we have here for a clarifier for some of this energy. Why is the King of Swords here for our beautiful Sagittarius reading? Why is the King of Swords? We have so many planets in Aquarius. Okay, so basically, you both really want to tell each other about things that have broken your heart. Now, the Three of Swords is Libra energy. You know, there's a tendency to juggle people. There's a tendency to break your heart juggling people. You know, that ego battles are going to stand in the way of a new beginning. That, you know, both of you need to come to this with temperance energy. Sagittarius, here you are again in your own reading. It's about being reasonable, calm, cool, collected. Be an angel. Don't talk about the past. Step forward boldly into the future. You have this beautiful dragon energy for you right now. You have the courage. You have the ability to forgive the past, forget the past, move on. You have a beautiful ability to bring this to fruition, my friends. So sending you love from Chicago. If you want to enter the contest, please like, subscribe, ring the all notifications bell, and leave a comment below. We're having the winners announced on the community page on February 1st. If you don't want to do those things to enter, check the subscription box below for another way, very specifically, that you can enter. And see you soon, hopefully in another video. Take care, Sag. Bye-bye.